This video is sponsored by Wix. Create your online store today at the link in the description below. Hey guys, my name is Christian Taylor. Welcome back to CrailerMade, where I talk about all things online branding and marketing. Today, we'll be taking a look at which email hosting solution is best for your small business. Email hosting is what you need to have a custom inbox with your domain name, like yourname@yourdomain.com. Having a custom email address is a basic way to stand out as professional, but it can be confusing to find the right email host. I think most people tend to stick with G Suite or Google Workspace because it's so popular, or they end up buying or using included email hosting from whoever their web host or website builder is. And while email hosting is email hosting, finding the right email hosting can save you time and headaches down the road. There's three main things to focus on when picking the right email hosting for you: price, reliability, and security. There's other aspects like features and privacy, but the main deciding factors come down to these three things. So let's jump in with my favorite email hosting solution of all time, Namecheap Private Email Hosting. If you've been watching the channel, you already know I love Namecheap. Starting at $11.88 per year with a 2-month free trial, private email hosting is affordable, reliable, and simple. If you're already a Namecheap customer, it's super easy to set up. If you're not a Namecheap customer and your domains are held elsewhere, that's okay, because you can still use private email hosting. If you want to give it a try, start with the 2-month free trial so you can set it up and see what you think. Namecheap gives you 5 GB of space with additional mailboxes and storage options available for a higher fee. With private email hosting, you're getting no-frills, reliable email hosting that just works. The online interface is nothing impressive. It's a clean and simple design, but it's no Gmail replacement. I find that private email hosting is best for those who want to use a desktop email client like Outlook or Spark. I use Spark, which is free for Mac, iOS, and Android. It connects with Namecheap private email and lets you manage email as expected. And sorry, Windows users, I don't really have a recommendation for you because it's been years since I've used Windows. I'm a Mac guy. In my years of using Namecheap private email hosting, I've always been extremely satisfied. The spam filter is fairly accurate. It's maybe slightly less accurate than Gmail, but it's sufficient in keeping the obvious spam emails from invading your inbox. The reliability is shockingly good for $12 a year. This is why I love Namecheap email hosting: the value. I use it on quite a few domains because it's affordable. It allows me to get started with a custom email with no money involved, thanks to the free trial. And if the brand continues to evolve and need a custom email address after the trial, I can maintain it for a very low cost. But what are the downsides to Namecheap private email hosting? Well, there's really only two: support and security. Namecheap offers 24/7 live chat support, but lately it can be a frustrating experience with reps who aren't very knowledgeable and are slow to respond. They'll eventually take care of your issue, but it's definitely not a great experience. I rarely need to reach out to their support, so it's worth it for me on a lot of domains to have cheaper email hosting and just have this trade-off, but it's definitely something to keep in mind when you're deciding what's right for you. Talking security, my beef with private email hosting is that two-factor authentication is offered, but it only applies to the online email client. Anyone could attempt to brute force your email account through a desktop client like Outlook or Spark, and they could essentially guess your password without two-factor authentication being required. You're only as strong as your weakest link, so in my mind, this is essentially saying you don't have two-factor authentication as an option with Namecheap private email hosting. This is what caused me to find a different solution for my hello@crailer.media email. As my brand grows, I start to have nightmares about the sensitive info that could compromise my business if found by hackers. If you're a small business or a low-profile creator, you'll be just fine with Namecheap private email hosting. And to be honest, I'd probably be just fine with it too. But for my own sanity and peace of mind, I recently made the switch to Google Workspace for the ultimate security protocols. More on that later. If you want custom email hosting with a focus on privacy and reliability, take a look at FastMail. Now, for full disclosure, I don't personally use FastMail. I'm mentioning it because it's got a big following and is known for having a strict privacy policy to protect your data. Available for $5 per month per inbox, FastMail is priced in the same tier as Google Workspace. You'll receive 30 GB of storage per user, also identical to Google Workspace, and your email will be hosted by a company that specializes in email. With FastMail, there's never any tracking, and you have access to human support. something that's hard to access with Google email hosting. FastMail supports two-factor authentication with app-specific passwords for email clients that don't support 2FA, giving this a clear security advantage over Namecheap private email hosting. So perhaps the biggest upside to FastMail is that they're dedicated to hosting your email. It's all they do. It's how they make their money. So you won't be sold other products or services, and your data is safe and secure. However, this also means that you don't have the convenience of a streamlined setup process. No matter where your domain name and website are located, you'll always have to take the extra step to link your domain with FastMail. Let's look at Namecheap private email hosting. If you purchased your domain name from Namecheap, in some cases you won't have to do any extra steps to link it with your Namecheap email hosting. You just purchase the hosting and it works. This is also the case with Google Workspace. Many domain registrars, website builders, and web hosts offer direct integration with Google Workspace, so you could simply purchase an account through your website builder and not have to deal with anything like linking to Google's servers or DNS records or any of that. Setting up email hosting doesn't have to be difficult. Thanks to today's sponsor, setting up Google Workspace is a breeze. It's one of the many features of Wix.com. The Wix e-commerce platform provides merchants, entrepreneurs, and retail brands with the professional tools and services you need to sell online and in-store. Manage and track everything with an advanced integrated dashboard. From inventory, orders, and fulfillment to payments and brand marketing, Wix lets you focus on what matters most in your business. Enjoy must-have features like customizable branded storefronts and carts, multi-channel sales, hassle-free drop shipping, extensive shipping and fulfillment capabilities, and more. Wix e-commerce aims to allow any business to have the same tools as big brands. I created an e-commerce store with Wix in less than 30 minutes. The dashboard is a joy to use, and I especially like the ability to calculate exact USPS shipping rates for each order, and the ability to automatically calculate sales tax with Avalara. The Wix e-commerce platform is home to over 500,000 stores worldwide. They help merchants by offering step-by-step guidance to build and grow an e-commerce business with the e-commerce school and online courses. Create your online store using the link in the description below. When you're done, go to your dashboard and get the Google Workspace add-on set up in no time. Thanks again to Wix for sponsoring today's video. Now let's answer the question, should you consider Google Workspace for email hosting? If you can justify the price, I believe it's the best email hosting out there. Personally, I use Google Workspace for my main hello@crailer.media email, and I use Namecheap private email hosting for my less advertised emails. So why did I pick Google Workspace over Namecheap for my Crailer Media email? I did a video covering this question that you can watch, but it boils down to three main things: spam filter, security, and reliability. As my business grows, my concern for my account security increases. Your email is the key to all of your accounts. If someone knows your email address and they can obtain access to your email, they can send reset password emails on all of your accounts and use your email inbox to get into the rest of your accounts. As my business scales, I want to know that I have the strongest security possible on my business email address. I love the peace of mind on my personal Gmail knowing that I have a physical security key securing my account, and someone can't try to log in with an email client and bypass two-factor authentication. Any mainstream email account supports Google's official login page, which forces the user to input the physical security key. And for old email clients that don't support Google's proprietary login method, I can set it up to automatically reject login attempts made from those programs. In other words, there's absolutely zero way to get around using two-factor authentication to get into my Google Workspace account. With Namecheap private email, 2FA isn't present on login attempts from email clients, and with FastMail, while they do allow app-specific passwords, that's a bit of a band-aid solution. There's nothing stopping a hacker from guessing that app-specific password via brute force and still getting into your account. You're only as strong as your weakest link, and if your weakest link is two-factor authentication every single time, then your account is pretty secure. Google's email hosting also has the most accurate spam filter thanks to Google AI. And it's Google we're talking about. You'll get the best-in-class reliability for your email inbox, and rest easy knowing that you won't miss emails due to outages or downtime. So, what's the case against Google Workspace? Cost and privacy. Google Workspace costs $6 per month per inbox, a high price to swallow if you're just starting your business. I've also seen many comments voicing concern for data privacy with Google. With a free Gmail account, it's no secret that Google accesses your data and leverages it for marketing and advertising purposes. The Google Workspace Terms of Service declare that these same practices are not conducted on paid Google Workspace accounts. After all, that's why they charge $6 per month per inbox. Still, some users are uncomfortable putting their sensitive business data in the hands of Google, and I can understand that perspective. There's no one-size-fits-all solution for email hosting for your business, but here's what I would recommend you consider. If you're just starting your business, or you're a low-target business like a local shop or service or freelancer, someone who's not going to be targeted by hackers like a big influencer with a lot of online followers, give Namecheap private email a try. They offer a 2-month free trial, and I don't think you'll find a better value on reliable email hosting. If you like the idea of an email host that only hosts email for a living and is committed to treating your data right, look at FastMail. It's priced close to Google Workspace, but that goes to show you that you're paying for your email hosting with dollars instead of data. You won't be sent email after email about other products they offer, and your data is yours and yours alone. If you want the best email hosting money can buy, Google Workspace is for you. You'll get the dependability of Google with all the benefits of Google's AI for spam filters, categorization, Smart Compose, and more. You'll also get unmatched security features that will ensure your account has maximum protection. You really can't go wrong with any of these email hosts, and if you do go the route of Google Workspace, remember that you can set it up super easily in your Wix account after you've created your online store. Thanks again to Wix for sponsoring this video. Let me know which email host you're using in the comments below. Make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss when I release new videos. And with that said, I will catch you guys next time.